So let's take a quick look where we are so far. What I first introduced to you is the concept of snapshots of the RAM. So you can look into the machine at any point in time that a polynomial time algorithm executes, and then you see exactly what state the RAM is at that certain point in time. So which line of the program it's executing and also what's in the memory. And I've now also shown you that we can represent a snapshot as a Boolean formula. What that means is that I've shown you how to construct a Boolean formula so that when you have a satisfying assignment for this Boolean formula, and there can be many, then you can reconstruct this snapshot from the satisfying assignment. What we also know is the assignment of the variables for the first Boolean formula, so at time point zero. And the reason why we know that is that at the beginning, we know what the machine is doing, because in the memory, there's the input, the algorithm starts at the first line, and in the memory where we have the output and intermediate results, there's nothing in there. So here, we already know what the variables are going to be. Now, why are we doing all this? In the end, what we want to show is, if we solve SAT for this huge Boolean formula that we're building, and we're not done yet, if we solve SAT for this formula here, then we want to know what the machine is actually doing. Or in other words, what we want to get is a protocol of what the algorithm here has done. So each of the Boolean formulas here represents a snapshot. But now we need to ensure that they fit together, because once the machine starts out in this snapshot, it will move to the next one. And so we must make sure that if we have an assignment for the variables here that represents a snapshot, then the snapshot that is represented here must fit together with this one so that it's kind of a valid representation of what the RAM is doing here. And the way we're going to achieve this is, of course, more Boolean formulas that we add to the game. And to do that, I would like you to think about some statements for a bit regarding how snapshots are connected to each other. So what I would like you to tell me is which of the following statements is true. The first one is, on a deterministic RAM, if we know what state that machine is in at a time point t, we can clearly state what the state will be at time t plus 1. The second one is, I want you to tell me if this here were true if instead of a deterministic RAM, we were talking about a non-deterministic RAM. The third one is, a non-deterministic RAM behaves exactly like a deterministic RAM, except when we use the if-better function. And finally, if we use the if-better function, there can be any number of next states. So not one, not two, not three, but basically an arbitrarily large number of states, and we cannot make any statement about that. So which of the following is true? Please check all the boxes where the statements are true.